耶和华，向耶和华
唱新歌，在圣民的会中赞美他。愿以色列应召他的主欢喜，愿锡安的民因他们的王快乐，愿他们跳舞赞美他的名，击鼓弹琴歌颂他，因为耶和华喜爱他的百姓，他要用救恩当作谦卑人的装饰。 Praise the Lord, sing to the Lord a new song, His praise in the assembly of His faithful people. Let Israel rejoice in their Maker. Let the people of Zion be glad in their King. Let them praise His name with dancing and make music to Him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes delight in His people. He's crowned the humble with victory. 弟兄姐妹，平安。今天我们又回到我们的这个线上的直播崇拜，感谢主给我们广东堂有这个机会继续的用直播敬拜来敬拜他。主啊，让我们弟兄姐妹同心合意的来赞美你。弟兄姐妹，让我们来站立，来唱两首的诗歌。 Thanks for the Lord. Let us have the chance to come back to the Lord's house to worship Him. Let us stand and sing two praise songs to give glory to our Lord. The first song, 诸天赞美， Praise the Lord, ye heaven, adore Him.Let us sing the second praise song. Day by day, 每一天，每一天我们都有主领导我们，都有主做我们的前路。让我们在这个诗歌上认识主的道，认识主的同在。 每当遭遇患难中求挂救，却靠我主尊称的应许，我却心主的体贴与安慰，身心身体应许不落空，恳求主生年日便如飞而去，只待尽应许美丽。弟兄姐妹请坐， Please be seated。
广东堂的弟兄姐妹啊，则这个班的弟兄姐妹平安。我感谢主，我们能够在这个线上，或者你要在家里面一起来敬拜上帝。
And we have online worship as well as we can worship at home。
那我们首先来看一段经文，今天经文是记载在这个的出埃及记。20:1-17。
Let us look at a portion of scripture from Exodus chapter 20:1-17.
今天讲的是十诫。
The topic today is the Ten Commandments.
出埃及记20:1，神吩咐这一阙的话说。
And God spoke all these words, saying,
我是耶和华你的神，曾将你从埃及之地为奴之家领出来。
I am the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery.
除了我以外，你不可有别的神。
You shall have no other gods before me.
不可为自己雕刻偶像，也不可做什么形象，仿佛上天、下地和地底下、水中的百物。
You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything in heaven above, or on the earth within, or in the waters below.
不可跪拜那些像，也不可以侍奉他，因为我耶和华你的神是祭邪的神，恨我的，我必追讨他的罪，自父至子，直到三世代。
You shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the fathers to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me.
爱我使我诫命的，我必向他们发慈爱，直到千代。
But showing love to 1,000 generations of those who love me and keep my commandments.
不可妄称耶和华你神的名，因为妄称耶和华的名，耶和华必不以他为无罪。
You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name.
第八节，当纪念安息日，守为圣日。
Verse 8, remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy.
六日要劳碌做你一切的工。
6 days you shall labor and do all your work.
但第七日要向耶和华你神当守的安息日，这一日你和你的儿女、父辈、亲属，城里寄居的客旅，无论任何工都不可做。
But the 7 days is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you nor your son or daughter.Nor your manservant or maidservant, nor your animals, nor the alien within your gates.
因为六日之内，神耶和华造天地海和其中的万物，第七日便安息，所以耶和华赐福与安息日定为圣日。
For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that is in them, but he rested on the 7th day. Therefore the Lord blessed the 7th day and made it holy.
当孝敬父母。使你日子在耶和华你神所赐的你的地上得以长久。
Honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you.
不可杀人。
You shall not murder.
不可奸淫。
You shall not commit adultery.
不可偷盗。
You shall not steal.
不可做假见证，陷害人。
You shall not give false testimony against your neighbor.
不可贪恋人的房屋，也不可贪恋人的妻子、父辈、牛鹿，并他一切所有的。
You shall not covet your neighbor's house, you shall not covet your neighbor's wife, nor his manservant or maidservant, its ox or donkey or anything that belongs to your neighbor.
啊，弟兄们，从出埃及记第二十章开始。
So from Exodus chapter 20,
是谈到以色列人民族认为最重要的律法的实践。
And to the Israelite, it is the most important commandment, the Ten Commandments.
实践这个名词很可能是从出埃及记三十四章二十七到二十八所借的话而来的。
And these Ten Commandments probably come from Exodus chapter 34, verse 27 to 28, where it was recorded.
那在出埃及记三十四章二十七节这样说，耶和华吩咐摩西说，你要将这些话写上，因为我是按这话与你和以色列人立约。
Exodus 24:27 says, The Lord said to Moses, Write down this word, for in accordance with this word I made a covenant with you and with Israel.
摩西在耶和华那里四十昼夜也不吃饭也不喝水，耶和华将这些的话，就是十条诫，写在两块板上。
Moses was there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights without eating bread or drinking water, and he wrote on the tablets the word of the covenant, the Ten Commandments.
耶和华将这些话，就是十条诫，就是十句话啊，写在这个板上。
So the Lord wrote these Ten Commandments, Ten words on the tablet.
所以十条诫原本就是十句话的意思。
So the Ten Commandments originally means the Ten words.
这十句话是这样写的。
And this one is written as such.
他说，除了我以外，你不可有别神。
You shall have no other gods before me.
不可为自己雕刻偶像。
You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything.
第三句话，不可妄称耶和华你神的名。
The third say, you shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God.
第四句话，当纪念安息日守为圣了。
Remember the seventh day by keeping it holy.
第五句话，当孝敬父母。
Honor your father and your mother.
第六句话是不可杀人。
You shall not murder.
第七句话不可奸淫。
You shall not commit adultery.
第八句话不可偷盗。
You shall not steal.
第九句不可作假见证陷害人。
You shall not give false testimony against your neighbor.
然后第十句话不可贪图别人的财产。
The Ten Commandments say you shall not covet your neighbor's house.
啊，弟兄们，你看到这个十诫中看到一个很重要的特点呢？
So you see a very clear point.
是一幅很明显的、明确的律法的条文，是上帝借着摩西赐予给以色列人要遵守的。
It's a very clear picture of the law that God has given to Moses for the people to observe.
但是不论是出埃及记的或是生命记所记载的十诫，
And whether the commandment was written in Exodus or in Deuteronomy,
都已经跟原来刻在石板上的十句话有一点点的差别了。
And we see that there is a slight difference from the ten words.
现在的十诫已不只是十句话而已。
So the ten commandment now is not just the ten words,
而是增添了许多的话语。
And there's quite a lot of addition to it.
而这些话语是后来才逐渐添上去的。
And this addition was made later.
虽然是如此，但是今天
，Even though it's such today,
十诫仍旧是以色列国立国的基本的精神。
The Ten Commandments is the foundational spirit of the establishment of the nations of Israel.
也是以色列国的立宪法的一个的基础。
And also the basis of the constitution of the nations of Israel.
那现在我们看回刚才我们所读的经文。
So let us look back at the verses that we have read.
在出埃及记二十章第一节到第二节。
Exodus chapter 20, verse 1 and 2.
一开始的时候，圣经说神吩咐这一切的话说。
In the beginning we see, and God spoke all these words.
然后神说，我是耶和华你的神，曾将你从埃及之地为奴之家领出来。
Then God said, I am the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery.
弟兄们，这两节经文可以说是十诫的前语。
So these two verses we can say is the preface of the Ten Commandments.
我们应该有一个基本的认识。
So we should have basic understanding.
十诫并不是用来作为得救的记号。
The Ten Commandments is not concerned about salvation.
而是为了要让以色列人要遵守上帝的话。
It's for the Israelites to obey God's word.
已经确实的遵守他们和上帝之间的所立的约。
And to make them realize that they are to keep this covenant，
成为上帝真正的选民。
So that they become the chosen people of God。
刚才是一开始的时候，第一节说神吩咐这一切话，一切的话说。
And just now you've seen that God spoke all these words。
这表示说摩西只能够传达上帝的话。
It means that Moses can only convey God's word。
摩西不能够增加或减少上帝所要讲的话。
Means Moses cannot add or subtract to the word of God。
这也说明了一个很重要的认识。
So it's a very important knowledge。
摩西是上帝所拣选的先知。
That Moses was the chosen prophet of God。
而先知的这是乃是要忠心的传讲上帝的话语。
And the role of the prophet is to faithfully preach the word of God。
换句话说，上帝要他讲说什么，他就说什么。
It means that what God wants him to say, he should say what God wants him to say。
而这些全部都是上帝吩咐他要讲的。
And all this have been called by God to him。
然后第二节说，我是耶和华你的神。
Verse 2 said, I am the Lord your God。
神将你从埃及之地为奴之家领出来。
Who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery。
你看第二节很重要，上帝在这边宣告说，我是耶和华你的神。
And verse 2 here is very important. It says, I am the Lord your God。
这句话成为了旧约圣经中描写上帝向他子民宣告的一个很重要的一个字啊词啊词句。
So this word speaks about what the Bible says that it is that God has declared through Moses。
上帝用这样的宣告来表示自己是发出上帝自己的话语。
And God made this declaration is meaning that He is the one who speaks for this word。
有很尊重宣布的用意。
Is about His declaration。
能让听者知道这个是非常重要，而且绝对不是一件可以随便的大事。
To let the hearers know that it's very important, they cannot simply do away with it。
我是耶和华你的神。
I am the Lord your God。
另一方面，也表示这个句话也表明上帝与以色列人之间的关系是不可以分开的。
It means the relationship between God and Israel cannot be separated。
这是因为以色列人和上帝之间有着越的密切的一个关系。
It's because the Israelite has a covenant relationship with God。
这种关系是以色列与神所立的约。
And this is a covenant that God has made with the Israelites。
而这个约是永远的约，是生命之约。
And this covenant is an everlasting covenant, the covenant of life。
然后在神在这提醒他们说：“我曾经将你从埃及之地为奴之家领出来。”
And God reminded them, "I brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery."
你看到吗？这个是表示一个历史的经验的关系。
So it's about the historical matter。
以色列人为什么今天有这样的今天的自由
？Why is it the Israelites today have such freedom？
乃是上帝从埃及这人手中将他们拯救出来的这个结果。
Because God had delivered them out of the bondage of Egypt。
所以上帝开始就宣告他和以色列人的关系。
So God declares this relationship between Him, God and the Israelites。
然后神就颁布了十诫给他们了。
And God。Gave them these ten commandments。
所以第一诫，上帝就告诉他们说。
So the first one say you say。
除了我以外，你不可以有别的神。
You shall have no other gods before me。
这是一个第一条的诫命。
And this is the first commandment。
是整个十诫中最重要的一条诫命。
And it's the most important commandment of all of these ten。
我们也可以说，所以十诫其实呢，十诫其实只有只是一条罢了。
So we can say the Ten Commandments, actually there's only one command.
就是这一条，除了我以外，你不可以有别的神。
And it says, you shall have no other gods before me.
而之后的九条诫命，也可以说是这第一条的诫命的延伸。
And we can say the other nine commandments is the extension of the first commandment.
如果这第一条的诫命不存在的话，
And if this first commandment does not exist,
你再继续说其他九条诫命都是没有什么意义的。
That means if it does not exist, then the other ten commandments is without meaning.
除了我以外，你不可以有别神。
Besides me, you can have no other gods.
这句话有一个很重要的意思。
So there's a very important meaning in it.
就是不可以将其他众神明 放在上啊上帝的面前。
That means you can put, cannot put other God before this God.
那你看英文那个 God 是后面 S 的，是很多的意思。
So in English, the gods, there's a plural on it.
就是其他的众神明用来敌对上帝，这是绝对被禁止的。
So the other gods that opposes this God, it is forbidden.
这样说来，一个人如果将一种事物或东西放在比上帝更高的位置，
it means that if we put something that is above God's position,
那就违反了第一条诫命了。
So it is against the first commandment.
因此，当这条诫命说除了我以外，你不可以有别神。
What is command say? Besides me, you can have no other god.
所要表明的乃是
，is express the meaning.
任何超过、越过对独一无二的上帝尊重，就是违反这条诫命，绝对禁止。
So, what is against this is forbidden.
讲到这里呢，《生命记》特别用了这样的话。说明了人应该如何用最恭敬、最高的态度来回应上帝的爱。
So here we can see from Leviticus, we must highly respect our God.
在生命记第六章四到九节这样说。
In Leviticus chapter 6 verse 4 says,
说以色列啊，你要听耶和华我们的神是独一的主。
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one.
他说：“你要尽心、尽心、尽力爱耶和华你的神。
You have to love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength。
那我尽了所吩咐你的话，都要记在心上。
These commandments that I give to you today are to be upon your hearts。
也要应许教训你的儿女，无论你坐在家里、行在路上、躺下起来，都要谈论。”
You have to impress them on your children, talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road.
也要系在手上为记号，戴在额上为。
Hands and bind them on your foreheads.
然后又要写在你房屋的门框上，并你的城门上。
And write them on the door frames of your houses and on your gates.
你看这短经文里面是整本圣经的中心的思想。
So this is the core teaching of the Bible.
它告诉我们建立一个正确的信仰的态度。
So it tells about the focus of our belief.
就是要用尽心、尽心、尽力爱耶和华你的神。
You are to love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength.
这样的人才能对上帝绝对的忠诚和忠心。
And such kind of people will always be faithful unto God.
因此，一个人的生命不能够存有两个的神。
So in the life of person, you cannot have two gods.
也不可以用敷衍的态度来回应上帝爱和上帝的呼召。
And you cannot have an ignorant attitude to respond to the love and the call of God.
所以你看到在这里，上帝很清楚的给了我们一个指示。
So here we see God gives us a very clear directive.
我们对上帝必须要绝对的忠诚和忠心。
So we are to be faithful totally unto God.
否则你就犯了第一条的诫命了。
If now you are opposing the first command.
所以第一条诫命是所有诫命的字母。
So the first command is the mother of all the other commands.
你必须对神尽心、尽心、尽力的爱你的神。
You are to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength.
下来第二个诫命。
And the second command.
在这边神说，不可为自己雕刻偶像，也不可以做什么形象，仿佛上天、下地和地底下、水中的百物。
You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything in heaven above, or on the earth beneath, or in the waters below.
这里的偶像是指到什么呢？
What does the idols here mean?
这里的偶像是指用石头或木头来做的，来做这个材料塑造出来的敬拜的对象。
And these idols are made from stone, from wood, from all this material to become a god.
会这样的指明的，其他有它的原因。
So here there is a reason for it.
乃是以色列人当年他们在埃及做奴隶的时候。
It was when the Israelites they were slaves in the land of Egypt.
以色列人时常跟做埃及人做这种雕刻偶像的事情。
And these Israelites they were with the Egyptians making these idols.
并且以色列人跟做他们埃及主人呢去敬拜这些用手雕刻出来的偶像神明。
And as a result, many of these Israelites They worship these idols together with their master.
而在迦南地的迦南人也是如同埃及人一样。
And the Canaanites in the land of Canaan, they were similar.
时常用雕刻的偶像作为敬拜的对象。
And they used these carved idols as the god to worship.
意思这里就说不可为自己雕刻任何的偶像。
So he said, do not carve an idol for yourself.
也不可以把天上地下所有的这些水族宝物来拜、做成偶像来跪拜这些像。
Or in the form of anything in heaven or earth, heaven above or the earth below and the waters below. You should not bow down to them and worship them.
这个诫命就从这个背景出来的。
And this is such background.
但是当我们知道出埃及时、我们知道早在出埃及记使用这样的字句，大家可以明白。
So when we realize the Israelites they were slaves in Egypt, we understand.
不过后来在被掳去当奴隶的时候呢，会有更深层的明白。
And after that they were exiled to Babylon, then we have another level of understanding.
偶像请崇拜并不是指到，只是指到那些可以看见、可以摸到的这些的事物。
And worshiping idol is just not about the external thing, the things that we are able to see.
而偶像更进一步的意思是，人的内心若对上帝不忠诚、不忠心，就是心存另一种偶像的意思。
So another level, it means that if we are not faithful to God, then it's also a form of idolatry.
那对于这件事呢，特别是在以赛亚书四十章四十八节，先知以赛亚这样说。
Especially in the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 18, the prophet Isaiah says,
你们究竟将谁比神？用什么形象与神比较呢？
To whom then will you compare God? What image will you compare him to?
以赛亚在四十章十到十一节继续说。
Isaiah in chapter 44, verse 10 to 11 says,
谁制造神像，造无意的偶像呢？
Who shapes a god and casts an idol which can profit him nothing?
看啊，他们的同伴都被羞愧，工匠也不过是人，任他们聚会，任他们站立，都被惧怕，一同羞愧。
He and his kind will be put to shame. Craftsmen are nothing but men. Let them all come together and take their stand. They will be brought down to terror and infamy.
你看，从这个先知的话可以说出，偶像不仅是可以看见、可摸到的偶像。
And from the words of the prophet, we see that these idols can be seen and can be touched.
而是更进一步说到那些引导人去敬拜偶像的这些祭祀人员。
And it also talks about those priests who lead these people to worship these idols.
所以说这些制造偶像的工匠也只不过是人，他们不是神，不应该去敬拜他们。
And they let us see that these craftsmen are nothing but men, and we should not worship all these things.
第五节，神说不可跪拜那像，也不可侍奉他，因为我耶和华你的神是祭血的神，恨我的，我必追讨他的罪，从自父至子，直到三世代。
So verse 5 says, you shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sins of the fathers to the third and fourth generation.Of those who hate me.
第六节，爱我、守我诫命的，我必向他们发慈爱，直到千代。
In verse 6, by showing love to a thousand generation of those who love me and keep my commandments.
这两节有一个相对的字眼。
So there's an opposing word.
一个是恨我的，一个是爱我的。
And one says about hating me, and one says about loving me.
恨我的就是那些用偶像来取代上帝忠诚，或是用别的神，别的偶像神明来与神对抗的，这个就是恨神的。
And those who hate God are those that make idols and other things to worship these gods.
就如在旧约讲到亚哈王，他们用巴利偶像神明来对抗耶和华上帝。
And it's just like Ahab in the Old Testament who used the god of Baal to oppose God.
这样做法就是恨神的。
And such kind of doing means hating God.
人如果离弃了上帝，一定是很糟糕了。
So if one who leaves God is very terrible.
但是还用别的偶像神明来对抗上帝的救恩，那实在是大大得罪上帝了。
And if they use other gods to oppose God, is really a big sin against God.
但相反的。
But then on the other hand,
爱我说。